It's race day in Budapest as we get ready for another round of the Formula One World Championship. We don't expect too many retirements at this track. There are plenty of current and former drivers with flawless finish rates here. In particular, Ralf Schumacher. He made it across the line in all 10 of his Hungarian Grand Prix starts. Located 12 miles northeast of the Hungarian capital Budapest, the 14 corners of the Hungaro Ring are steeped in history and prestige. Overtaking has always been difficult on this technical 2.7-mile circuit, but the last few years in particular have turned up some exceptional races. Let's hope we're in for another one here today. It's race day yet again, and joining me for a chat, Anthony Davidson. Ant, our racers are certainly in for a rough day today. What will you be watching for as they go down into turn one?
Well, the start of the race is always one of the most nerve-wracking parts. You have to hope that everyone is able to get off to a clean start, and this is possibly the trickiest part of the entire race. So many drivers in such a small space, and finding your braking point into turn one as well. It's a testament to the driver's skill that there aren't more incidents.
With the race minutes away from starting, here's what today's grid rundown looks like. A fantastic effort from Charles Leclerc yesterday puts him on pole, and Lando Norris lines up alongside. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Sainz, Bottas, Pierre Gasly and Stroll, Verstappen, Tsunoda, Ricciardo and Joker, Joe, Russell, Antonio Giovinazzi and Latifi, Perez, Ocon, Jack Aitken, and Mick Schumacher, Eilert, and Nikita Mazepin. And now, it's time to head down to the track.
Okay, good work, great pass. We can now use DRS. DRS now available. We're approaching the pit window. You'll be on the mediums. A new strategy is available on the MFD. Copy. Gap to car in front is 2.7 seconds. Okay, keep on him. He might make a mistake. We want to pit this lap, so push now. Exit now. You'll be racing as you leave the pits. Release, release. Okay, stay clear of the white line on the exit. We'll receive a penalty for dangerous driving if you cross over into the track. Valtteri is in the pits. Okay, gap ahead is 10.5 seconds. Gap behind us is 1.5 seconds. This pace is strong, but be aware your tyres need to go the distance. Our gap to the car in front is 1.5 seconds. The car behind is dropping back by about 0.3 a lap. There's 5 laps of fuel remaining. gap to teammate ahead is 27.4 seconds. The gap to the car ahead is 4.2 seconds. There's three laps of fuel remaining. This is your final lap of the race. Currently, the fastest lap is a 1 minute 14.2. The car in front is 3.6 seconds. There's only one lap of fuel remaining. All right, race over. Take care of the car on the way in.
Yet another historic win under their belts. Well done to the team at Mercedes. Tell me, Ant, how do you think they were able to deliver such an incredible result today?
Well, they certainly stood out as a driver with tons of confidence on the track. I think their ability to keep their cool, even during some of the more hectic parts of the race, meant they were able to capitalise on the mistakes of other drivers, giving them the opportunity to make their way to the top spot with ease.
So after a magnificent race, we can now see the drivers making their way to the podium. Once again, it's the Silver Arrows who take top spot, a well-earned victory for Mercedes. That lead at the top of the table has shrunk somewhat today. Now, let's discuss, Ant. Who would you say is a contender for driver of the day?
Let's give it to Esteban Ocon. That was a commanding performance today. Very impressive indeed.
Let's move on to the constructors. The lead at the top comes down after a strong weekend from the challenging pack. Meanwhile, Ferrari have improved their position. A strong weekend from them as they fight their way towards the top. It's been an absolutely wild weekend of Formula One action. I can't wait to see what's next.